what the haters are doing is not there anymore. You're putting lives in danger. Anybody that knows me on the internet or in real life, you are putting them in danger. Whoever it is, you're putting lives in danger. And it's not funny anymore. It really is not funny. You put children in danger, several children in danger, all with special needs. It's not fair anymore. You need to leave me alone. Move on. It's getting boring. Start your new chapter. But it also shows that you're nothing without my contents or pinching my live streams. Without me, you're nothing. Even though you do go live for your own self and you haven't done for a few months, you could easily use them videos of your own and do a proper YouTube channel, because I know you've got a proper YouTube channel, and maybe do that and build your own channel, not based on me. None of that you're claiming in them videos. I have done, or my partner done, is true. Absolutely none of it is true. None of it. So you're literally falsely accusing myself and my partner for things we have not done. Nothing. We haven't done any of it. We haven't. So yeah, get a grip. Smell the air outside. For once, step outside your front door. For once, get some sunlight in your face. For once, see there's a world, not just my world. You love to live in my world. It's pretty clear here. You'd love to live in our world, and you'd love to be me and Peter. That's pretty obvious. But you need to realise we're not yours. You have never owned me and my partner. You do not own the rights to copy anything I'm doing as your own. And part two of the chapter of this bullying, obsessive behavior part of this person. Here's the message I got from my father-in-law first thing this morning. You need to get a life, love. You need to get a life. You need to get help in mental support. If Taylor can do it, surely you can. You really do. There's a lot I'd like to say on here, but I can't. That's a hell of a lot. And part two.